Jedi strength flows from the Force. But beware of the dark side. Use the Force. Lift the stone. Reach new heights, you will.
I can't let you down, Master Yoda.
The dark side of the Force, are they?
I don't know about the dark side.
Am I a Jedi Master yet?
Once you start down dark path, forever will it dominate your destiny. Consume you it will, as it did Obi-Wan's apprentice. Nothing more will I teach you today. Clear your mind of questions.
Wait, there's something not right here.
When she pulls the tape measure back out, it's got
that
blood and hair on it.
Strong with the dark side of
wrapping around her limbs and head,
a domain of
the
evil.
Then the whole thing erupts in a geyser of blood that coats the entire bathroom. What is this, a Sam Raimi joint? When Al comes in and asks about all the yelling, he doesn't see the blood at all. Let's keep this haunted house scares coming with Bill. He's chilling in George's old room with a Lego turtle when he sees a raincoat-clad figure running around in his house. He follows it to the basement where Julie emerges from the corner to apologize for losing Bill's boat. Yo, kid, it was a freaking piece of paper. Don't worry about it. Julie invites Gordon to come with him and advertises the benefits, namely that he'll float too.
He'll float too.
Oh, fuck, that's not Georgie. That's Pennywise and his famous Georgie handcuff. Sam likes that. Well, Georgie sees each other later and Bill notes the fuck out of him, leaving Pennywise behind to slither away in the trees. Sam has the boys over, and as Vicious stands watch outside, she shows them her bloody bathroom. They can see the blood, proving that she's not crazy town banana balls. And with a montage set to the fear, they help her clean it all up. Ben's still carrying a torch for that, but it looks like she was going to Bill, even assuming it was him who wrote the poem. But when she brings it up, he doesn't know what she's talking about.
Can I end this?
The other kids are going to finally share their terrifying clown victory. Although Rich is the only one who has that first experience, remains in disbelief.
Can we get Rich to see this stuff?
She fights Mike on the side of the road next to Belcher's car. So Ralph pulls that Mike up around and trying to make a new raw meat. And if that weren't bad enough, Mike also sees Pennywise waving to him from the bushes. Tying down Mike before Bowers can smash Mike's head, it's been right in the mouth thrown by Ben. All out fucking rock warfare now, including metal music and some slow motion cartoons. God damn, it seriously takes Mike down to the head and I got up in the corner brain bleeding? Man, get the guys back from that. The losers at the bloody experiment are contender behind with a bloody beat. As part of their victory parade, they induct Mike into the real game. As they hang out together and look at a poster of the missing kid, he starts developing a message to bear. Every 27 years, some bad event happens around, like the Easter explosion, the black spot fire, and the recent rash of missing kids. The business will seem like it's been taking the most, like in the Two Brothers or Eddie, where the world is changing for Stan.
She hot? No,
but she's not hot. Edward missed his vision. The charred hands behind the burning door comes from a nearby experience. His parents were burned alive inside a building during the case of arson. He was there to see it. And when asked what he's afraid of, Richie admits that it's not. I've got some bad news for you, kid. We go to Bill's garage and project a map of Gloria and the sewer system on the wall. We notice that every location in the tragic history behind it is connected by the sewer.
All right, Chewie, let's get out of here.
Scream! Dear God, that is one big ass clown! They end the nightmare by opening the garage door, and Bill immediately wants to go to Depot Street to find George.
Let's get
the others
ready for light speed. It's not fair. We've got to find a safe port somewhere around here.
Bill delivers a stutterless speech
far,
about
but I think we can make it.
So the game resolves to go inside, except Sam raises the point that maybe we should go inside. And that's where we'll end part one.
I hope this investment place is as safe as you're making out.
Relax. I know a guy down there who will take good care of us.
Until then, I'm James H. Beast, and this has been like half a kill count. Thanks a lot for watching my kill count for Hit 2017, the first part. I want to thank a couple of my patrons like Elliot Rivera and Kodiak Sacks.
Very friendly.
So, what are you doing here?
Ah, repair. I thought you could help me out. What have you done to my ship?
Your ship?
Hey, you lost her to me fair and square.
It's the hyperdrive.
All right, I'll get my people to work on it. Care to join me for a little refreshment? Hey, Lando, you want to have another game of Sabacc after this?
Very dark, 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 very